We're here in a simulation lab where air traffic controllers train. We're here to train at LAX Airport, and you're going to show me how to land a plane, right?
Well, we're going to depart a couple airplanes.
Okay. We'll send some off.
Okay, here we go. What you see out the window is exactly what you see when you're in the tower. So once he's on the runway, and you know that there's no conflictions, scan your runway, make sure no traffic, issue takeoff clearance.
Southwest 416 cleared for takeoff. Is it normal that your hands are sweaty?
Yes, in the beginning it is.
This is stressful.
Each strip represents an aircraft and a flight plan. The destination has a call sign on it. It's like a road map in the sky. We need to move these airplanes here across this runway because the guy on short final right here will not be able to land. So you better make a transmission now. Southwest 725, go around. Do it now.
Southwest 725, go around. So the poor people on that plane now are circling the airport because I'm too slow.
The runways are these lines here. There's two lines there, and then you'll also notice two lines here. The white are the actual aircraft that are coming in. This is a ground radar display, and this shows the controller exactly what you see as you're looking out the window. Did you watch him land? You should have made sure that the runway was clear when he landed.
this is very hard.
It's extreme concentration. It's a mental game. It does get a little tiring.
Redwood 865, cross runway 24 left.
Now you're getting it. We can introduce rain with lightning. You also have the capability to show snow. Working in the dark, it adds a tremendous amount of complexity because you can't see as well.
Taka 531, cleared for takeoff.
Perfect.
Those people are happy.
Yes, they're happy.
Cactus 297, runway 24 left, cleared for takeoff.
And we're out of airplanes.
Yay, that is a great feeling. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Sandra Endo, CNN, Los Angeles.